You have been watching extreme minimalism videos for quite a long time on the internet. In almost all the videos, what you can see is well-arranged, very clean white houses, people mainly wearing monocolors, I think it's black or white, and they speak very polished, calm and composed. You're scared. At the same time, you have a desire to start minimalism, that is to own less and to declutter. I was also here. So if you are here, this video is for you. First of all, I don't think there is a definition for minimalism. There is no hard and fast rule to become a minimalist. Hi, my name is Jessly and you're watching Jessopedia. According to me, minimalism is to make our lives easier, simpler, and finally reaching the epitome of happiness. The most commonly used word by almost all minimalists is decluttering or organizing or clutter. Clutter doesn't mean a heap of clothes or heap of shoes or unwanted stuff which we can find in our houses. Clutter is something which is disorganized. So clutter can be in our routines, clutter can be in our mindset, clutter can be in our relationship, and clutter can be our lifestyle. It can be in our houses also. We are just worried about the clutter lying in our garage or in our houses. I can share some tips with you to start with. Sometimes you may like the journey of minimalism, sometimes it may not suit you. So we'll just discuss some tips which we have to practice when we are starting minimalism, or in simple words, if we are beginners. The most basic step to try out if you want to start minimalism is to start slow. The moment idea of minimalism strikes you, there is no need to go and throw out things or donate things from your house. There is no need to declutter on day one if you are planning to start minimalism. Before decluttering, before making space, we have to change our buying habits. Some of us may be buying things which we may not need at all. Some of us may be shopping as a hobby. For some of us, shopping may be a stress buster. Some of us may be shopping to impress our friends or neighbors. Some of us may shop if there is a sale, if there is discounts given, or something is in trend. Or if you want to start the journey of minimalism, the first thing is to cut the flow of things coming to your house. I'm not telling don't buy stuff. I'm just trying to say that we have to check what we are buying, what we need. Basic step towards minimalism is cutting the flow of unwanted stuff coming to our houses. The second very practical step is to have experiences over buying things. Sometimes the experience may give you happiness more than the things which you buy to your houses. For example, you can call a friend, or you can visit your old friend and have a good time. You can have a nature walk with your family. You can go to the woods. You can go to anywhere where there is greenery. You can go to any place where you may not end up buying things or spending your money. You can spend your time with your family inside your house and still have a beautiful experience. The experience which I have cited are the things which I can relate to. You can have different experiences. In one sentence, if I say the second important or the second simple step is to have experience over things which we can buy with money. Sometimes this experience can give you more happiness than your shopping. The third step is to start with easy stuff. By easy stuff, I here mean just junk or waste. What is waste? Something which is out of use can be called a waste. I can give you some examples like old newspapers or worn out shoes or clothes which you cannot use it anymore. Sometimes if you are trying to declutter other stuff, your family members might have a difference of opinion. Next step can be a continuation to the third step. That is, don't declutter the hard stuff. By hard stuff, I mean mainly sentimental stuff. It can be photos, it can be gifts, or it can be some books. Many people love to read and keep the books forever with us. So if you are trying to declutter your books, still okay, but if you're trying to declutter your partner's books or your family members' books, you have to think twice. So it's better not to touch such items. Even toys can come to this category. The moment we take a toy to donate or to throw, children will not be that happy. So keep all this sentimental stuff to the next level. The next tip, which I am going to share, is one of my favorite tips because it worked perfect in my case. That is to declutter your stuff first. There is no need to ask permission from anybody else to declutter or arrange or to throw out or even to donate if you are decluttering your stuff. I can give you some examples. Your shoes or your clothes or your skincare or your area or workspace or your kitchen or any place. And if you come across some stuff which you can donate, you can do that. But again, I'm using the first tip here, that is to start slow. Never do anything in a hurry. If you try giving out everything and after some time, if you have a change of mind, you are going to be upset. At the same time, your family is also going to be very upset with you. My sixth tip, or my next tip, you can try if you are a little bit used to decluttering or arranging or a minimalist life. So now you have tried all other steps and you know that you're enjoying what you're doing. So this tip is about decluttering a small space or decluttering one portion at a time. By one portion at a time, I mean it can be one kitchen shelf, not the complete kitchen, or one shelf in your cupboard, one shelf in your bathroom, or one portion of your wardrobes. If you are deciding to declutter only socks, that's enough. You can start with only handkerchiefs. That is best for you because you will not end up throwing much of the stuff. At the same time, you will get a feeling of what you like and what you may not. Give a break and give some time to sink in. You may like it afterwards, you may not. Even the family may agree to you or may disagree to you. So just give some time after decluttering a small portion or after decluttering one thing at a time, to see that you are enjoying the process. You are becoming different for better. You are becoming more happier and more calm and composed. And even your family is enjoying the act as well. My next tip may sound very simple, but it is very important when you are considering whether to start this journey or not. The idea is to figure out why you want to start this journey. Is it because someone else is doing? Is it because your favorite influencer or your favorite friend is doing? Or do you think that minimalism is a trending topic? Or do you really believe that by telling I'm a minimalist, you look intelligent or you look cool? Is it because I'm enjoying the journey? Is it because I'm enjoying the time spent in decluttering? Or is it making me a calm person if I don't worry about my possessions? So all these you have to figure out. Whatever may be the reason, you have to figure out why did you start this journey and why do you want to continue this journey. If it is giving you happiness, do it. Don't do for any other reason. The next tip is a very practical hurdle we are going to face if we start anything, let alone minimalism. That is, what will people think? What will people say? To be honest, people are so busy, they don't have time to sit and watch what are you doing inside your houses. There may be someone who can make fun of you. There may be someone who think you're a little bit weird, but there will be always well-wishers or our loved ones who are going to be with us, whatever may be our journey. Just focus on your journey and continue. Initially, people may call us weird, but later on, either they will get inspired by us or they will get used to that little part of weirdness. My next tip is an extension to the previous tip. That is to expect questions from people. People are so much used to us and our lifestyle. A slight change can also evoke curiosity in them. So it's very natural to expect questions from our loved ones. You can even expect some mean comments. My next tip for beginners in minimalism is to never force minimalism on anyone else. There is no need for you to force minimalism on anyone else, even if they are your family. When you yourself are trying to figure out whether to start minimalism, whether to continue in this journey. Anyway, if people like it, they will follow you. The way you carry yourself and the way you behave may inspire them. My last tip in this video, if you are a beginner to minimalism, is to surround yourself with like-minded people. If you are surrounded by people who are into impulsive shopping, especially almost all the weekends, you will be in a dilemma. You don't want to say no to that person because she is your friend. You yourself are trying to figure out whether you will like minimalism or you will continue minimalism or not. These are some tips I tried and became so successful with my journey. There is no perfect definition for minimalism, or there is no rule set in order to become a minimalist. There is no need to copy or get influenced by any popular minimalist. It is their journey. They are taking it in their way. There is no need for you to sell almost all your possessions like your house or car and move into a very small house. Or there is no need for you to wear only white clothes or only black clothes. Don't compare your journey with any other minimalist journey. It's your life. It's your choice. What makes sense to you may not make sense to the other person. What you need may not be needed by any other person. So it's your decision. Whether you can call yourself a minimalist or not, it's up to you. If you consider yourself minimalist, that's enough. This is your journey. You can make your rules. You can prioritize your needs. You can prioritize what you need to buy. You can plan how you want to live, how you want to declutter, how you want to arrange your house. If it works for you, that's enough. This is the reason why most of us are scared to start minimalism, because in our mind, minimalism is something very difficult to attain. All the steps mentioned above are the steps which worked perfectly for me. I don't know whether it is going to work for you or not, but still you can give it a try. If you ask your grandmother or any elder person in your family, they might not use the term minimalism. For them, minimalism is just good housekeeping. That is to keep your house clean, spacious, healthy, and to save some money. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please give a big thumbs up. Share it with someone who want to try minimalism or who is new to this journey. To conclude, minimalism is not the only way of life, but definitely it's a good way of life. The final goal should be to attain happiness and live stress-free, and not to become a so-called perfect minimalist. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to smile and love yourself.